Hello YouTube, I'm DK Katie here and I'm back with another Beyblade Burst Turbo unboxing. This time we're going to be looking at Archer Hercules H4. Alright, so here's the box for Hercules H4. And up here we got the graphic for Hercules, Hercules H4 right there, Slingshot, and it's part of the Beyblade Burst Turbo line. You got the launcher right there and the parts on the other side. And here are the parts right there, and let's just focus on the stats of this Beyblade. It has 2 attack, 1 burst, 3 defense, 4 weight, 3 agility, and 10 stamina. It has a lot of stamina. Hopefully it actually works properly. It has 2 speed and 4 power. So let's compare TT to Hasbro. So here's the TT tip, Eternal. And it is by far the best one of the best stamina type tips in the metagame so far. It's basically a POM revolve type tip. And here's the Hasbro one. It's not a POM revolve type tip. In fact, it's basically survived with just a ring around it. It has very little contact with the stadium, but the one good thing is that it has a good spring. And it can go in Slingshot mode, so we have to line it up with the arrows on the side. And I'm not going to try struggling, so here's a cut where I actually do it properly. And you just pull up from those arrows and bam. And there's no lock up here, which means this is going to be the worst Slingshot driver of them all. Because the moment you launch it, it's just going to go back in, which is really, really disappointing. I wish Hasbro had created a lock for this Beyblade's driver, because honestly, this looks pretty darn cool. Of course, it's not going to be competitive, nor will it be even good in Turbo's meta right now. It just looks cool, but it won't work. And yeah, so here are the discs, 13 and 13. New one, the Hasbro one is shinier because it's new. They're pretty much the same disc, and apparently Hasbro discs are lighter. I can't really feel that with my arms, right, with my hands right now. I really need a scale to determine that. But they look the same, they feel the same in my hands. So let's look at the layers finally, and the major difference of course is that there is no metal and it's way lighter than the TT one. The one good thing is that they kept the gimmick of Archer Hercules where the bows extend, and that's cool I guess, but without the metal it doesn't really affect its stamina that much. I mean it may, but like it doesn't feel that, I don't feel that difference. Now, the other major difference is that the black piece right here is all one plastic, and the gold piece is a lot thinner than the TT one. Yeah, so they're cutting out on plastic as well, which is really disappointing. I really wish they did not do that. I don't understand why they're cutting out plastic. Just remove the metal and replace it with gray plastic. It makes sense. You shouldn't have to, like, change the entire mold of it, because that's exactly what they did right now. So here's the QR code, and here's the QR code, and that's all I have to say for Archer Hercules. Now we're gonna be putting it together. All right, so let's put this bad boy together. Now I was testing this spring alone on the driver. It feels tighter, and here's the QR code if you want it. I think I already gave it in, but like here's it again. But yeah, the driver itself feels pretty tight, so it should, wow, okay. So it is very tight. Yeah, the driver really does help it. If this had metal, this would easily replace the Archer Hercules that we have in the normal meta right now. Hercules H4 would take over. And that's really nice to believe, but they didn't put metal on it, and it's just a tight Beyblade that doesn't do anything, which is very, very disappointing.